What is formula for magnetic induction due to elemental length by Biot-Savart's law? Formula for magnetic induction according to Biot-Savart's law. Yes, what is formula for magnetic induction due to Biot-Savart's law?
Idl sin theta upon r square.
Mu naught upon 4 pi idl sin theta r square. Correct. Trupti, what is formula for magnetic field at the center of circular coil? Yes, Vansi. Formula for magnetic field at center of circular coil. Formula for magnetic field at the center of circular coil. Vansi?
Yes, sir.
Formula for magnetic field at the center of circular coil.
I2R.
I2R. What is I2R? I2R.
No, I2R.
R2R? From where? What is this R2R?
Radius of loop.
R2R?
No, B is equal to I2R.
I2R, this way?
Yes.
This is formula for magnetic field at center of coil.
Sir, mu naught I2R.
Mu naught I upon 2R. You are daydreaming or don't to practice the formula or theory or numerical after lecture is over? Absurd answer you are giving. Whenever B, it has to be something connected to mu naught. Magnetic field due to finite current carrying conductor. So consider finite conductor AB carrying current I as shown in the figure. At a point P near the conductor at a distance A, we want what is magnetic field. To get magnetic field, first I have to consider elemental length, then I have to do integration. So consider elemental length dl at distance L. Consider elemental length dl at distance L from, let us take O. So magnetic field due to elemental length dl at point P will be given by mu naught I dl sin theta upon r square. So at this point P, magnetic field due to elemental length. Suppose P is making angle theta at distance r from dl, then magnetic field we know PB equals to mu naught upon 4 pi I dl sin theta upon r square. Now if this is theta, then angle between line joining dl and r will be 90 minus theta. So from this we can get dB equals to mu naught I dl sin 90 minus theta is cos theta upon 4 pi r square. But we want the field when current is going from B to A and length is changing from B to A. So this angle, suppose downward side is phi 2 and upper side is phi 1. So we have to keep only theta variable, which is from phi 1 to phi 2. Rest all we have to convert into constant. So net induction is actually integration of dB, which is integration of mu naught I dl cos theta upon 4 pi r square. Downward is minus pi 2, upward is plus pi 1. Copy this much. So for finite conductor, where O to P A angle is phi 1, O P B is angle phi 2. We have to find what is induction. Yes, completed till that. Mu naught ideal cos theta upon 4 pi r square.
Yes, sir.
From this figure, can you tell what is cos theta? Adjacent side A upon hypotenuse R. So wherever I see cos theta, I can put A by R. And R is A upon cos theta. A is constant, R is variable. So I'm trying to eliminate this variable R and keeping the answer only in theta variable. So this is minus phi 2, 2 phi 1, mu naught I dl upon 4 pi r square will become a square upon cos square theta into cos theta into cos of theta. That will be equals to mu naught constant, I constant, 4 pi constant, a you can bring outside. So inside we get dl into cos square theta into cos theta upon a square. Just copy it in this, then dl we will try to eliminate. DL variable, theta variable, two variable we cannot integrate. So I'm converting again DL in terms of theta. So from that figure, again in this right angle triangle, A L R theta, we can say tan theta is opposite side L upon adjacent side A. So L equals to A tan theta. Therefore DL will become A sec square theta D theta. From this B will become mu naught I upon 4 pi DL is A sec square theta into cos square theta upon a square into cos of theta. Sec and cos are reciprocal of each other. So it will get cancelled. Sec square theta into cos square theta is 1. Because sec is 1 upon cos. Into cos theta d theta. 1 a gets cancelled. Sec square cos square cancel. So we get b as mu naught I upon 4 pi integral of cos theta d theta from minus pi 2 to pi 1. Therefore, b equals to mu naught I upon 4 pi. Cos integration is sine theta from minus pi 2 to pi 1. So, b becomes, okay, please copy till this.
So what we have written below a sec square theta cos square theta.
A sec square theta cos square theta cos theta d theta upon a square.
Okay.
So this part I have
Sir.
This I have went ahead from here to here.
Sir, cos theta upon a will come now with.
Where?
So right hand side cos theta upon a. 1 a will remain after cancelling.
Yeah, I'm bringing up, sir. So therefore, B equals to mu naught I upon 4 pi A sine of pi 1 minus of sine of minus pi 2. Sine of minus theta is minus sine theta. So this will become B equals to mu naught I upon 4 pi A sine of pi 1 plus sine of pi 2. Pi 1, pi 2 are angle between OP to A and OP to B. So this is formula for magnetic field due to finite straight conductor. Mu naught I upon 4 pi A sine of pi 1 plus sine of pi 2. Can I clear this screen?
Yes, sir.
Now, case one, if conductor is infinite. Case one, infinite straight conductor. So if this is AB finite conductor, it is going upward indefinitely from downward indefinitely. So if this is P, if you draw a line joining from this O, P to top end here, just imagine what angle it will make. If it is here, then angle is theta, increases, 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 increases. Finally, it will become very large. Hello?
Yes, sir.
This will be going to very large position. That means it will tend to 90 degree. if it is joined from here to here to here to very large, so that means it will tend to here 90 degree. Same way from lower side it will tend to 90 degree. So phi 1 will become 90, phi 2 will become 90, B will become mu naught I upon 4 pi A sin 90 plus sin 90. Sin 90 is 1, so 1 plus 1 will become 2 into 2. So this is mu naught I upon 2 pi A for infinite long conductor. Right. Yes. अरे आपको एक बार फोन लगाया आपने उठाया नहीं था, हो गया 15 मिनट में कोई रहेगा तो उसको भेजना ना जरा, वो पैंतीस का मुझे रिमबर्स कराना है। हाँ हाँ जो था मुझे याद नहीं, वही है। हाँ अच्छा दे देना, अगर होता रहेगा तो। हाँ 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 ओके बोले। इसमें हो जाएगा। क्या रेट है, क्या अभी क्या आएगा उसका वैल्यू क्या है? चलेगा मैं देख लूँगा। Yes, done.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, suppose it is semi-infinite, then what? Then I'm starting with MCQ. Semi means one side finite, infinite, other side infinite. Okay, case 3. Semi-infinite. So from one side it is increasing, other side it is fixed. So this is B, this is A going infinity, this is point B. So can I say here, phi 1 is 90 and phi 2 is 0. Therefore B is mu naught I upon 4 pi A sine 90 plus sine 0. So B will become mu naught I upon 4 pi A sin 90 is 1 plus 0. Mu naught I upon 4 pi A. Right. So when it is finite, then mu naught I upon 4 pi A sin pi 1 plus sin pi 2. Infinite, then mu naught I upon 2 pi A semi infinite, then 4 pi a into b. So total we have done 5 formulae so far, including small elemental and 6 formulae. Now around 10 to 12 MCQs I am doing so that you get idea of formula. Completed?
Yes, sir.
First, numerical. Finite conductor carrying current I. There is a point P here. Current is 2 ampere. Making angle. 30 degree, 45 degree and 30 degree. Now B is mu naught I, its distance is 10 meter, upon 4 pi A sine pi.
Sir, have you sent the PDF?
Which PDF? This is numerical I'm doing. Some already have written on this. Drawn the diagram. PDF I have not yet sent. First I said 10-15 sums I am doing based on numerical type where you will be able to by heart the formula. So P is a point at a distance 10 meter near finite conductor making angle 45 and 30 as shown. We want to find what is field at P. So formula for finite is mu naught I upon 4 pi sine phi 1 plus sine phi 2. Now mu naught upon 4 pi, PDF I have not sent, afterwards I am sending 2 ampere because I am not doing from any PDF, I am giving the question. Mu naught I is 2, distance is 10, phi 1 is 45 degree and phi 2 is 30 degree. Therefore we will get sine 45 is 1 upon root 2. Mu naught upon 4 pi, if you know it is 10 raised to minus 7. Into 2 upon 10 1 by root 2 plus sine 30 half. So just leave like this. I want you to memorize the formula for that few questions I am doing numerical based. Done?
Yes, sir.
Second one. Conductor is in the form of square. Current I is passing through the square loop as shown in the figure. Each side is of length A. Each side of length A. Find B at P due to all sides of square. Find field B at center P due to all side of square. So center is nothing but point of intersection of diagonal. Here we want field. If all the current is giving field me in one direction, then if I find answer of 1, I will multiply by 4 to get the required answer. Current is in clockwise. So what will be direction of field? Inward or outward? Say current is in anti-clockwise. So what will be direction of field? Inward or outward?
Outward.
So due to this first conductor outward, due to second also outward, due to third also outward, due to fourth also outward. So if I find answer due to first, I can multiply by 4. That will give me resultant. So this is now finite conductor AB. Distance of P from AB first I should know. Can you suggest me what will be this angle? 45? This is 90.
Yes.
So what about this angle?
45.
Correct. 45. This angle also 45? That means yes. If you start from this conductor, suppose I call this point as M, MPA 45, MPB 45. So can I say here, phi 1 is same as phi 2 is equals to 45 degree? Phi 1, phi 2 means ye wala. And perpendicular distance from P to M, suppose I call R. Can you say this is tan 45? This is diagonal. Or this distance are same because it is isosceles right angle triangle. So can I say R is A by 2? This much followed?
Yes.
So now B due to one side, then we'll see from all the side, equals to mu naught I upon 4 pi A by 2 sine 45 plus sine 45, which will become 2 times mu naught I upon 4 pi A 1 by root 2 plus 1 by root 2. Any doubt? So 2 times mu naught A 4 pi, mu naught I upon 4 pi A, 1 upon root 2. 1 upon root 2 is 2 upon root 2. This 2 into 2, 4 you can cancel. So mu naught I upon pi A root 2. Any doubt till this?
No,
any
sir.
Doubt? So now net field will be 4 times B, which is 4 times mu naught I upon pi root. So this is the answer. Yeah. Copy full answer and nature will be out there. Thank you. Yes, completed one.
Yes, sir.
See the next one. Now I'm showing equilateral triangle loop. So all sides are equal. It is carrying current in clockwise. We want direction. We want what is field? Equilateral triangle. So it has got total three sides. If all the fields are in same direction, then whatever answer I get for one, I will multiply by three. Current is carried by this in clockwise direction. I. We want field at the center. At P, I want field. Each side is of length L. Find net field at P due to all sides. Net field due to all sides. What will be this angle? Is it 30 degree? This is 30 degree. So this two will become 60-60. That means this is 30-60-90 triangle. Hello? Okay.
Yes, sir.
So this distance, if I call A, this distance, P2M, so we can say P2M perpendicular drawn from the circle of center of circle bisects the side. Center of this P bisects is perpendicular, bisector, angle bisector, the only bisector, all are same in equilateral triangle. So can we say tan of 30 is opposite side A upon adjacent side L by 2. Tan 30 means 1 by root 3 equals to 2A by L. Therefore, A becomes L upon 2 root 3. So I got perpendicular distance of P from one of the side, L upon 2 root 3. Now, B due to one conductor is mu naught I upon 4 pi A sine of 60 plus sine of 60. That will become mu naught I upon 4 pi L upon 2 root 3 sine 60 is root 3 by 2 plus root 3 by 2. So 2 root 3 into mu naught I upon 4 pi L. This will be 1 root 3 by 2. 1 root 3 by 2 is 2 root 3 by 2. Hello? Now this 2 will get cancelled. So we get 2 times root 3 into root 3 is 3. That is 2 into 3 mu naught I upon 4 pi L. Therefore, net field B is 3 times any one field. So 3 into 6 mu naught I upon 4 pi L. 2 into 2, 4, 2, 3 is 6. 9 upon 2 mu naught I upon 4 pi L is the result and answer. And direction will be inward. Cross means inward. Thank you.
Done, sir.
So now you got idea of the formula sine phi 1 plus phi 2, what how to use. Next, see. These are two circular coils having radius R1 and R2, carrying current I1 and I2 in opposite direction. I want net B at O. Find P at O. Can you tell what will be direction of magnetic field due to I1? Inward or outward?
Inward.
Inward, because it is clockwise. And B2?
Out.
Out. Net result will be difference of these two. Net result will be difference of these two. So this is then mu naught I1 upon 2 pi R1 minus upon 2 R1 mu naught I2 upon 2 R2, which is mu naught upon 2 common I1 R1 minus I2 R2. Okay. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Now I don't know value of I1. I don't know value of I2. So whichever is larger minus smaller. So that means if first term is large, then we'll get answer inward. Second term is large, we'll get outward. Okay. Hello.
Yes.
If suppose I1, I2 are of same magnitude. If by chance I1, I2 are same magnitude, then clear cut R1 denominator is greater. That this answer will be smaller. And R2 is smaller, this will be larger. So it will give you answer outwards. So depending upon the magnitude, if given, we can say out in. Here we cannot say because I don't know who is greater. First term or second term, who is greater, we don't know. So just try this. Once you complete, say then another figure I'm showing. Next question. This is center O. Current is moving in a anti-clockwise. This distance is R1 and outer distance is R2. We want net field at O. Now current is constant this time. For first one, see there are total four sides. Huh? 1, 2, 3, 4. But for first one, it is straight wire where point is on the side if you extend. So B1 is 0. B2 will become half of mu naught I upon 2 times R1. B3 is also 0 because point is on that body, on the conductor. B4, this is current is in clockwise, so inward. B4 is half of semicircle, so half mu naught I upon 2R2, but outwards. So net field B equals to, can you tell now who is greater, B2 or B1? Sorry, B2 or B4? Who will be greater?
B2.
B2.
B2 is greater because its denominator is smaller. B2 is greater than B4. So net will be B2 minus B4, which is mu naught I upon 4R1 minus mu naught I upon 4R2. That is mu naught I upon 4, 1 upon R1 minus 1 upon R2. You can leave answer like this. This time I can predict the nature because inward is more. So result will be inward. Okay. Cross means inward, dot means outward.
Done, sir.
Next conductor. This is subtending angle theta here at O. This distance is B and this radius is A and current is moving in clockwise direction. Find B at O. Find B at O. So if I mark, this is first conductor, this is second, this is third, this is fourth. Now this conductor ke upar there is point O. So B3 is zero, B4 is also zero. B1 will be theta upon 2 pi into mu naught I upon 2 times radius A. And because it is clockwise, direction will be inward. B2 will be same, theta upon 2 pi given mu upon b theta upon 2 pi mu naught I upon 2r wala formula, and b2 will be theta upon 2 pi into mu naught I upon 2b, but this is directed, this is in clockwise. Hello?
Yes, sir.
For b1 it is anti-clockwise, so it will be actually outward, and b2 becomes clockwise inward. This time b1 is greater or b2 is greater? b1 is greater than b2 because its denominator a chota hai. So b net will be b1 minus b2, and final answer will be outward direction. Then whatever you get, that will be answer. Theta upon 2 pi mu naught I upon 2 common inside 1 upon A minus 1 upon B. Sorry. 1 upon A minus 1 upon B. So in MCQ, they will give you such options. Theta upon 2 pi mu naught upon 2, 1 upon A minus 1 upon B.
Done, sir.
From infinity, it is going upward in semicircle, center O, and from this side going to infinity. Third one. Find net field at O. Net field at O. So for first one, it is semi-infinite wire, and field will be inward by right hand from rule. So it is mu naught I upon 4 pi A sine 90 plus sine 0, if you know direct this formula. Sine 90 plus sine 0, that means mu naught I upon 4 pi A sine 91 sine 0 0. Directly also you could write mu naught I upon 4 pi A directed inward. and B2 is nothing but half of full circle. So half into mu naught I upon distance, if I take A here, so radius is also A, directed inward. For B3, point is lying on the conductor, so zero. Therefore, net will be B1 plus B2. Then whatever answer comes after adding. Copy.
Sir. Sir, mu naught I upon 2A, B2.
Mu naught I upon 2A, B2.
B2 will be half into mu naught I upon 2A.
B2 is half of mu naught I upon 2 times radius. Yes, 2, half of 2.
Done, sir.
Next question. This is straight conductor coming from infinity carrying current I. I call this as first one. We want B at A. What will be B1? This is semi-infinite wire.
Mu naught I upon 4 pi.
Inward or outward?
Inward.
Inward, yes. Inward at O. And for second one?
Inward.
Direction will be inward and magnitude will be 1/4 of mu naught I upon 2A. Okay? What will be B3? mu naught I upon 4 pi A, and direction again inward. The net field will be B1 plus B2 plus B3. Then whatever you get answer, that is. Follow this first, second, third, all the three direction inward, inward, inward.
Yes, sir.
Can I clear this?
Yes, sir.
X-axis, y-axis. This is one semicircular coil. Center O, radius AA. Carrying current I, and along z axis we have a wire carrying current I coming from infinity, and then from here it is going parallel to this I up to infinity. So this is like one wire, second one, third one. Find B at O. Now see, this is three-dimensional figure. So first conductor, it is carrying current I, and because it is semi-infinite, at least I can say magnitude wise it is mu naught I upon 4 pi. Now where is the direction? See, always remember dl bar cross R bar ka direction is dB bar, and dl bar is current ka direction. What is direction of current? Can you tell? Inward or outward? Current in first is inward or outward?
Inward.
Inward.
Inward means J cap or K cap or I cap or minus K cap, minus J cap, minus K cap. Inward is
minus K cap.
Minus. And R means this distance. It is on the right side. Right side means, can I say plus I cap? What is K cross I with this circle? Wala method, if you know. What is K cross I?
J cap.
J cap. So this will become, pehle se idhar minus hai, and K cross I is J cap. So my magnetic field ka direction is along J cap. Downward. So can I say it is minus J cap? In vector form ho gaya pura. Okay, followed. Magnitude direction both. Now B2 is half of mu naught. It's very difficult some day, so that direction also you understand. Upon 2A. Abhi ye to clear hai. Kaun sa direction hai ye? Inward na? देखो इसके लिए डाउनवर्ड हो गया, माइनस जे मतलब डाउनवर्ड, एंड दिस इज इनवर्ड बाय राइट हैंड थंब रूल. करंट इज क्लॉकवाइज, सो इनवर्ड. दैट मींस इनडायरेक्टली माइनस के कैप इज बी टू. B3 का डायरेक्शन मैग्नीट्यूड म्यू नॉट आई अपॉन फोर पाई ए डायरेक्शन. व्हाट इज डीएल बार का डायरेक्शन आउटवर्ड ना डीएल बार इज प्लस के कैप एंड आर बार लेफ्ट सो माइनस आई कैप. व्हाट इज के क्रॉस आई हेलो के क्रॉस आई A cross I
minus J.
So result will be minus J, that is downward. So net field is addition of these two because both are downward. So I can say B net is equals to 2 times mu naught I upon 4 pi A minus J cap minus of half of mu naught I upon 2a k cap. This is my resultant. Everybody followed full? This is a bit difficult sum because direction is not only outward, inward, downward bhi aa gaya. Anybody who has not followed this sum? Hello, everybody has followed?
Yes, sir.
Please copy properly. Very important sum. If paper is difficult, it comes this time. Always remember magnetic field ka direction is along DL bar cross R bar. That means in the direction of current is DL bar, R bar is position vector, can be right, left, up, down. You can see from the diagram. If they ask magnitude, it will be Pythagoras theorem of first term plus second term.
Done, sir.
One more 3D type only. y axis current is coming from infinity. Is I center O AA. We have got semicircle YZ exit plane. Exit plane. This is going up to infinity. Current I coming and going from here up to infinity. Find B at O. Find B at O. For B1, it is mu naught I upon 4 pi A because it is semi infinite wire. What will be direction now? At point O? Outward, inward, I, K, J, any method? Think here. DL bar is coming downwards. So minus J cap. R is along right. So I cap. What is J cross K at O? J cross I? What will be J cross I? See from this diagram. I cap, J cap, K cap. So what will be J cross I? Yes, what will be J cross I?
Minus K cap.
Minus K. And already minus is there, so it will become plus K cap. So this is K cap direction. K cap means outward. B2 is mu naught I upon 2A half. Now direction. DL. Yes, what is direction of DL? Or it is YZ plane, therefore it is directed along X, Y. So it will be directed, XZ, it will be directed along Y. So DL for B. So the bolo kitna I DL bar, iska DL bar, is it along I cap? Cross this distance from here is along Z. That means it is K cap going inward. So minus, what is I cross K? I cross K? Hello? From here to here, plus way. I cross K is J, na? So it will come J cap. Because from point, if I come outward, this is plus K. B1, B2, both direction followed?
I cross K minus J.
I cross K, you are going in J cross K. I cross K we want, na? So this is from the center to the conductor. Position vector is outward means plus K. I K is minus J. Yes, this will come minus J. Minus J. I cross K. We are going in clockwise, therefore it is minus J. What about B3? Yes, straight conductor ka upper and a point, so it will be zero. Bas, this is our answer. So B net will be equals to mu naught I upon 4 pi A K cap. Plus of mu naught I upon 2A into half of minus K. This is net. Two. Okay, done?
Done, sir.
Circular coil. Current enters from one end, gets divided into two parts. Suppose this is I1, this is I2. This is angle subtended theta by one conductor. Very important sum. We can ask ratio of magnetic field due to two part or net field. So if I consider current I entering here as first conductor, this as second part, coming up till this, and this as third part, I2 wala, and this is fourth part, straight conductor. Radius is R. Find magnetic field at O. This is center O, this is radius R. Now clear cut, you can see this straight conductor has center on the line. So B1 is zero. Even B4 is zero. Only due to curved part we are going to get magnetic field. This is going in clockwise, so field due to second one will be inward, and due to third one will be anti-clockwise outward. So first one is current is going clockwise, so it will be outward. Mu naught I1 upon 2R if it is full circle, but because it is part of the circle, total angle this side will become 2π - θ. 2π - θ upon 2π. And for third one, mu naught I2 upon 2R, angle is theta upon 2π. If I get I1, I2 in terms of I can get the answer. So B net will be equals to V3 - V2. Please copy this one. Copy it. Just complete till this, then I am finding what is I1, I2 in terms of I. Okay. The diagram clear kar deta. Now see, this is that upper part of conductor. which is subtending angle 2 pi minus theta, and lower part is subtending angle theta. So it's like two resistance R1, R2 are carrying current I1, I2 and parallel to each other. Total current is I. So we know in parallel I1 into R1 is same as I2 into R2. So ratio of I1, this is rho length L1 upon area. This will be I2 rho length L2 upon area. Rho A you can cancel. Length is nothing but arc. This length L1 is nothing but arc of first one. What is length of arc formula? Radius into angle. So this is R into angle 2 pi minus theta. And this is I2 R into theta. R are cancelled. That means I1 into, okay, you can leave like this, equals to I2 into theta. Let this be equation 2. Now our first was V3 minus V2. V3 is mu naught upon 2R into 2 pi. I'm taking common. Inside I will get I2 theta. V2 equals to I2 into theta minus of I1 into 2 pi minus theta. Here we are getting both are equal. So net answer will become 0. So B net equals to 0. Copy full. I1 into 2 pi minus theta is I2 into theta. So that's what their difference is 0. Net field is 0. So whenever you see current enters and gets divided into two parts, whatever may be the case, net is always 0. So whatever is first coil may field, same field is in the second coil. And their net is 0 because one is outward, other is inward. So what will be ratio of the field in two parts? If you want to take ratio, then V1 and V3 ratio will be 1. And that is the reason why the difference became 0. So just complete, then I'm giving you notes so that you didn't solve in exam such a lengthy expression. Done. Can I clear this to write that note?
Yes, sir.
So in exam, you will definitely not do like this because it is too lengthy for you to do in 1 minute. But definitely, I can remember the concepts. If this is the coil, current I is entering at one point A, comes out from another point B. So this current will get divided into two parts. So whenever you see current gets divided into two parts, then ratio of field in the two part is same and net field will be always 0. Write this way. So no need to solve full. Ratio of the field 1, net field 0. Once they had asked what is ratio of the field. Ratio of field in the two part is 1. Net field is 0 because one is inward, other is outward at the same time. So So I have completed for you all everything related to magnetic field due to semicircle, due to part, due to wire and combination. Next class will start with magnetic force acting on charge and current carrying conductor. So one part of the chapter we have completed. Next class we'll do magnetic force, magnetic on the charge, on the conductor, then if time is there, Ampere's circuit and law. And then moving coil galvanometer, ammeter, voltmeter. That will complete this chapter. Completed full?
Yes, sir.
So that's all for today. Next lecture is extra class on Thursday, I will keep.